show you my view on these sessions, okay? So, no more remembering mine. Let's quickly go through some of this. I think you should have done this in maybe some of your home learning or before we broke up from school, but I think you're so sensible and so lovely here, you're meant to know these already. So, number one, influence is when a person or thing affects your choices. True or false? You can talk to me.
True.
Yeah. So influence is when somebody is, they're trying to change the way you're thinking or feeling or what you're doing. They're trying to promote something and make you do the same. What are the benefits of positive, healthy online relationships? Really relevant to this year. We've been online so much. Okay. I'm sure lots of you are online, talking, communicating with each other. So what are the benefits of positive, healthy online relationships? Now I want you to focus on relationships, how you communicate with other people. What are the benefits of using online to do that? So try one. What's the benefits of speaking to people online? Reliable, okay, so reliable in which way? Explain more.
If there's anything that's happening, if you live far away, it is still quite reliable and you can chat to each other quite
easily. Do you mean easy access?
Yeah.
That's what we were talking about, weren't we? We were saying you won't have to allocate so much time and fit it into, we're all busy, I know everyone's so busy at the moment. To have to find that time to physically go to somebody's house, especially if they live far away, find that time in your busy schedules to actually communicate with somebody. It's a lot more, it's more easy to access. Yeah, great. Also thinking about that, thinking that if they live far away, what other benefit could that be if somebody's far away? Or have you got a different idea?
Yeah.
Yeah, go for it.
Is it the background of the COVID and pandemic,
Yeah.
Is that less safe if you wanted to go to your friend, it makes you live all the way to like somewhere else in Poland or India or anything like that. It was like some colour clothes. So yeah. It's not all the videos.
So you've got 2 points already. You actually built on the point I was trying to make. So that's amazing. So first of all, in a global pandemic like we've been through, we can still communicate. A lot of people relied on that really heavily to stay in communications and still have those relationships with people. It stopped people from really suffering and feeling really lonely. So it was really important this last year. But then also you were going on to, when people live in separate countries, you're still able to keep in contact with those people and keep those solid relationships going. So that can be really positive, yeah?
Also, if you're like lonely and you have no one to talk to, some of your friends, and if you have online friends, you can talk to them. And like they might, and you can like, it's even if you don't know them and you know that they're someone reliable and that they know much about you, that
okay.
They can like help you and
yeah.
Keep you like keep you.
Supportive,
yeah.
Being supportive? Yeah. So, I like that idea. So, I want to also work on that idea a bit more in that. So, if you're talking to strangers. Some people might not feel confident enough to share how they're feeling with people they know. They might feel embarrassed. They might not feel confident. So, if you're talking to a stranger that you're not going to meet, that might actually help with that confidence. However, that's where we need to be careful as well, don't we?
Yeah.
So, although it's going to help us to feel confident and we can maybe share and say, oh, I'm going through this situation, I wonder if you can help, this is how I'm feeling. Yes, a stranger might be able to safely give you some advice on, oh yeah, why don't you try this, why don't you try that? However, it is a stranger that is not a trusted person, no matter how well you think you know them, you do not. Simple as that. You could be talking for ages. You do not know them. You cannot trust them. Therefore, the experiences you might be sharing, don't include personal information ever. Don't tell them your name. But of course you could ask a stranger online for advice and just say, I'm going through this situation, don't really know what to do about it. As soon as they start asking questions that you think, hold on a minute, you don't need to know my name, you don't need to know my friend's name, you don't need to know my family's name, you don't know positive benefit, although that might sound really fun. Shared interest. That was one we didn't discuss, but some of you maybe discuss that with your partners. You're able to share interest, things that you enjoy, with strangers. Again, just being careful of that personal information. Making money. That's, I wouldn't say that's a positive thing out of a relationship. You're not there to make money, you're there to just be supportive of somebody. Yeah? And meeting strangers in person. Definitely not. So that just goes on that point that we were discussing. That's not a positive relationship. Meeting a stranger in person, that's not what we're there. That's not what we're using it for. Yes, Ellen? Not unkind and mistreat people, there is a difference. Okay? Inequality.
Inequality.
So, that is when a person or group do not experience the same rights or treatment as others do. And that's what I was just saying. That's what we don't want. You are more than entitled to say, I don't agree with that, I don't believe in that, that I don't like that. You can say that. That's fine. But you're not going to mistreat someone. You're not going to treat them differently. You wouldn't say to them, no, sorry, you can't have that job because I don't like the way you play boxing. You have no right to do that. You have a right to say you don't agree. Fine. I actually spoke to one of my year ones today. And I said to one of my year ones, oh, you like football and I like dancing. If I said to you, no, I don't really like football. I don't think you should be playing football. Do you know what that year one's response to me was? 5 years old. That's okay. That's it. You don't agree? Okay. That's fine. But we're not going to be unkind to each other because we don't agree. That's the message we're saying. Legislation.
Legislation.
That's laws that are passed to change how we behave. Now, a lot of this unit is about people that fought. They campaigned. They fought to make sure that these people were not treated badly. They're not fighting to say that you all have to agree with it. That's, no, of course you don't have to agree. You can say, no, I don't agree with that. But they fought to make sure that they weren't treated badly. They're still a person. You can't force someone to agree the same as you, just like they can't force you to agree with them. But they're still a person. They still have human rights, the same as all of us in here. Sexual orientation.
Sexual orientation.
So this is what gender of person they are attracted to. So we know that as grown-ups grow up, they form relationships with each other. We know that already. Lots of grown-ups in here are together in relationships. That's what happens. As you grow up, you become more responsible and you can choose your own relationships as you grow up. Yeah? We all know that. LGBT.
LGBT.
This is an acronym that stands for lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender. All that means definitely more mature than that. I love how sensible you're being. All these are words that just describe those grown-ups that decide to be in relationships with the same sex, different sex, or they identify themselves as a different sex to what they were born as. Okay? These are just all grown-ups that have made choices. You can disagree with it. You can say you don't like it. You can say I don't believe in that. That's okay. But what you shouldn't be doing is treating them unfairly or being unkind to them. Just like they have no right to do that to you either. For any reason. Skin, religion, age, boy, girl. Your people. You all have the same human rights. Okay, so we're going to move through. So lesson contact. So what symbol is used for the LGBT community? So now we're talking about that community. Yeah? We're talking about lesbian, gays, bisexuals, transgenders. These adults that have made these choices and that's the life they're living. Okay. We're thinking about what symbol is used for this community. Well, Nazis, you've learned about Nazis already?
No?
I
already know a lot about them.
Back in Germany a long time ago, Nazis were very unkind to Jewish people, okay? They were really unkind to them. So the Nazis forced people they labelled as gay to wear an inverted pink triangle. They didn't ask them if they were gay. They just assumed. They said, right, I think you look a bit gay, you're going to wear that pink triangle. Strange. Point at someone and say, right, I think you look this, so that's what you are. Excuse me? Only you know yourself. No one can tell you. They were treated as the lowest of the low in the concentration camp. They were treated disgustingly, inhumanely. It's not okay. They're still people. The Nazis could have said, we don't agree with that. We don't like that. But instead they treated them inhumanely. The way that they made these people live was disgusting. And that weren't okay, that was against their human rights. They're still people. Despite what they are doing, despite how they look, despite how they feel, despite what relationships they've chosen to live like this in an inhumane manner because we believe that that's what you're doing. It's not okay. So, here's the symbol that they were given. They had to wear it so everyone knew. That meant that everyone that saw you wearing that symbol, that's it. You were treated with so much disrespect. You had no rights. All human rights that you think you had were gone. A man called Harvey Milk wanted to create a new symbol for the LGBT community. Because he didn't want all that, all those memories, all those feelings, all of that injustice to be crumbled. Because that symbol was almost like a memorabilia. They remembered how they were treated and why they wore that. He didn't want that memory to be linked to this anymore. You thought, well, that weren't okay the way you were treated back then. You can say you disagree, fine. But that treatment was not okay. He hoped it would be one that they called, one that they could use to unite around and challenge discrimination, prejudice, and inequality. Think back to what we spoke about: discrimination, prejudice, and inequality. He wanted to challenge, he wanted to forget. He did not want people to remember the way these people were treated, the way they were discriminated against, the way that people just said, nah. I just don't like it. We're just going to treat you badly because we can. Because we're powerful and we can. You're different to us, so fine. They could have done that to anyone, any community. They could have done that to a religious community. They could have done that to a racial community, a race. They just chose these people and they decided, a bit like bullying. Yeah, you are the community that we're going to torment and discriminate against. They were treated unfairly. So, Harvey Milk, an American politician, he was the first openly gay man to be elected to public office in California. He believed that gay people should not face inequality and discrimination. Quite right, nobody should. We're not interested in your relationships. We're not interested in what race you are, what religion you are. That's not important. I'm just interested that you are a person and you have the same human rights as me, as my best friend, as my family. Every single child here has the same human right, despite what you look like, despite what you believe in. And that's all he was campaigning for. He was just campaigning that we can't keep doing this to communities. We cannot keep doing this to people. A long time ago, it was to erase if you were non-white. If you weren't white, they discriminated against you. That went okay. Yes, sweetheart.
When they Rosa Parks.
Yeah. Exactly that.
In that she, even though they had, she went on the bus, this was a white person. She was like, no, I'm going to sit there. That's not fair.
Exactly. Just like Rosa Parks. And I'm glad you brought that up. In fact, turn to your partner. Can you now remember, in all of your schooling life so far, can you remember ever learning about a community that was discriminated against? A religion, a race? Turn to your partner and tell them about it. Do you remember a community that was discriminated against? Do you remember any communities that were discriminated against? Do you remember any communities that were discriminated against? You can understand that this is just another community, again, that was treated unfairly. That had to change. Someone had to make that change. Okay, so I'm just going to go past that. So, Harvey's legacy. He sponsored the civil rights bill that made it illegal to discriminate against someone based on their sexual orientation. Fantastic change. Amazing. Remember, again, I cannot say this enough. This legal bill, Harvey was not saying that you all have to agree to it. right and this is okay. No, you all still have your freedom of speech. Of course you do. You still all can have your own views, your own opinions. You can still all say, I don't believe that because, I don't agree with that because. But just do not discriminate. You cannot mistreat somebody because of their choices or the way they are. And that's what this legislation shows. We cannot discriminate somebody from getting a job because of their relationship. That makes no sense. What if they were the most fantastic, outstanding teacher? You would want that teacher to teach your children. If they were amazing at teaching, I want that teacher to teach my children. It doesn't matter what race, religion, sexual orientation they are. That doesn't matter. They can still be a fantastic teacher. And that's what we're saying today. Okay? So we've now gone on to the activities. Lisa, do you mind pausing the iPad? Thank you so much for letting me start this unit of learning for you.